हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द डिजिटल क्लासेस ऑफ क्राइस्टचर्च कॉन्वेंट गाडावारा। आई एम दीपक कौरव, यूअर इंग्लिश टीचर। टुडे वी विल डू द एक्सरसाइजेस ऑफ योर ग्रामर बुक पीसी रेंस ग्रामर ऑफ क्लास सिक्स। सो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास सिक्स, टेक आउट योर पीसी रेंस ग्रामर बुक एंड ओपन चैप्टर नंबर सिक्स, एंड द नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज pronouns. I have already uploaded a video on this topic, pronouns. First you watch that video in which I had explained pronouns and its type. So it would be helpful to you to understand this chapter, and you can easily do the exercises given in your grammar book. So let me tell you what is pronoun. Okay, a pronoun is a word which is used instead of a noun. Okay, so a word which is used in the place of noun is called pronoun. Okay, like if I say Ram is a good boy, Ram is also good in studies. So if I use pronoun instead of noun, then it will become like he is a good boy. Here he is Ram, and he is a if we say about he is a pronoun and which is used in the place of noun. And what was noun at that time? Noun was Ram. Okay, now we are using he is a pronoun. So he is a good boy, and also he is good in studies. Okay, so now kinds of pronoun. Basically there are 10 kinds of pronoun: personal pronoun, interrogative pronoun, indefinite pronoun, relative pronoun, possessive pronoun, reflexive pronoun, emphasizing pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, reciprocal pronoun, and distributive pronoun. Okay, so these are the types of pronoun. So personal pronoun, a simple substitute used for the proper name of any person, place or thing is personal pronoun. I repeat, a simple substitute that is used for the proper name of any person, place or thing. Okay, a word which is used in the place of any proper name of any person, place or thing is called personal pronoun. And the second one is interrogative pronoun. Interrogative pronouns are being used in a questionable format. Okay, now third one is indefinite pronoun. So indefinite pronouns are those pronouns which refer to one or more unspecified object. Keep this in mind, it is a pronoun which is used to refer to one or more unspecified objects, beings or places. Example: some, any, few. So these words are used to refer one or more unspecified object. Okay, now fourth one is relative pronoun. Okay, so relative pronoun is a word that is relative pronoun is a word that introduce a dependent clause and connect to the independent clause. Okay, so relative pronoun is a word that introduce a dependent clause. Okay, it introduce a dependent clause and connect to the independent clause. Now fifth one is possessive pronoun. Okay, so possessive pronoun shows relationship of any person or thing to any other person or thing. Okay, it shows, keep this in mind, possessive pronoun shows relationship of any person or thing to another, to another person or thing. Example, mine, hers. Okay, now sixth one is reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun are words ending in self or selves. Okay, now seventh one is emphasizing pronouns. Emphasizing pronouns are always stands after noun or a pronoun. Okay, keep this in mind, emphasizing pronouns always stands after noun or a pronoun. Okay, and reflexive pronouns always stands after verb. Keep this in mind, reflexive pronoun always stands after verb. Okay, now demonstrative pronoun. Demonstrative pronoun that points specific objects. Okay, so these pronouns points specific object. They take place of noun, noun phrase, activity or any situation. Okay, so these are demonstrative pronoun. Now reciprocal pronoun. What is reciprocal pronoun? A reciprocal pronoun is a pronoun which is used to indicate that two or more people are carrying out or have carried out an action of the same type. Okay, and the last one is distributive pronoun. Okay, distributive pronoun. Each, either, neither are used with reference to a number of persons or things on things one at a time and are called distributive pronoun. So a pronoun that considers members of a group separately rather than collectively is known as distributive pronouns. So this pronoun considers members of a group separately rather than collectively is called distributive pronoun. Okay, so let's do our exercises that are given in our grammar book. Exercise first. Underline the personal pronoun in the following sentences and say for what each stands. Okay, for what each stands. The boy stood on the burning desk whence all but he had fled. So here he is a personal pronoun and it is a masculine pronoun. Okay, now second one is no mate, no comrade, lucky new, she dwelt on a wide moor. So here she is a feminine. Okay, feminine gender. Oh, Alice Brown, my native land is lost for love of you. So here you is for both masculine and feminine. Okay, here you is a personal pronoun and which is used for both masculine and feminine gender. Okay, awake, awake, my little boy, I thou wast thy mother's only joy. Okay, so here thou is basically used for you. Okay, and you is basically used for both masculine and feminine. Behold her single in the field yon solitary highland lass. So here her is a personal pronoun and which is used as a feminine gender. Okay, have you got it? It's your exercise first. Now let us do exercise second. Fill in the blanks with the correct possessive pronouns. So what you have to do, you have to fill correct possessive pronouns in the blanks given in this exercises. I gave her my phone number and she gave me dash. So let us see. I gave her my phone number. Okay, and she gave me dash. So here objective case depends on the subjective case of second clause. Okay, so here I gave her my phone number, it's first clause. Okay, and she gave me dash. Okay, so here she gave me dash is second clause, and objective case always depends on subjective case while inserting possessive pronoun. So she, with she there will come hers. Okay, now second one, I gave him my phone number and he gave me dash. Okay, so here subject is he and its possessive pronoun is hims. He gave her his phone number and she gave him dash. Here she is a subject and its objective case would be hers. Okay, they gave us their phone number and we gave them dash. Here we is a subjective case of second clause and its objective case will be ours. She gave him her phone number and he gave her dash. Here he is a subjective case and the objective case will be his. He gave me his phone number and I gave him dash. Here I is a subjective case, then mine. I's possessive form is mine. Okay, we gave them our phone number and they gave us theirs. You gave him your phone number and he gave you his. He is a subjective case, then its objective case will be his. Okay, she gave you her phone number and you gave her yours. Here you is a subjective case and in objective case here it will come yours. They gave me their phone number and I gave them mine. Okay, here I is a subjective case and the objective case will be mine. Now exercise third, what you have to do, you have to underline the pronouns in the following sentences and say which are emphasizing and which are reflexive pronouns. Write E for emphasizing pronouns and R for reflexive pronoun. I repeat, you have to underline pronouns. First you have to underline pronouns. Either it will be emphasizing pronoun or it will be reflexive pronoun. Then after underlining, you have to write whether that particular pronoun is emphasizing pronoun or a reflexive pronoun. Before doing this exercise, I would like to repeat what I had told you while starting doing this exercises, I told you something about emphasizing pronouns and reflexive pronoun. So here I will repeat, emphasizing pronouns, what emphasizing pronouns always stands after any noun or a pronoun. Okay, keep this in mind. Emphasizing pronouns always stands after any noun or pronoun. And reflexive pronouns always stands after any verb. Okay, after any verb. Let us see. I will do it myself. Okay, so here it is a pronoun. So as I told you that emphasizing pronouns always stands after any noun or pronoun. So it is a emphasizing pronoun and you have to underline myself. Second one, he hurt himself. First you underline himself, then as we can see here, himself is coming after a verb, hurt. Hurt is a verb, and if any pronoun himself comes after any verb, then it would be reflexive pronoun. So here himself is a reflexive pronoun. I posted the letter myself. Here letter is a noun and myself is coming after any noun, that's why it is a emphasizing pronoun. So you have to underline myself and write E for emphasizing pronoun. Fourth one, the governor himself gave the prize. Here himself is a pronoun, so it is also an emphasizing pronoun. Then fifth one, I blame myself for it. Here blame is a verb, then it would be reflexive pronoun. Then I shut the gate myself. Here gate is a noun, so it is also an emphasizing pronoun. Then seventh one, the boys hid themselves. Here themselves is coming after hid. Hid is a second form of hide. Hide's second form is hid. And it is reflexive pronoun. Why? Because it is coming after verb hid. Okay. Now eighth one, pray do not inconvenience yourself. So here yourself is reflexive pronoun because it is coming after a pronoun. Okay. Now sorry for the mistake, pray do not inconvenience yourself. Here inconvenience is a noun, so it would be emphasizing pronoun. Then ninth, you may hurt yourself. So here hurt is a verb and yourself is a reflexive pronoun. Then she poisoned herself. Here poisoned is a verb, then herself would be reflexive pronoun. He set himself a hard task. So here himself is coming after a verb set, so it is also a reflexive pronoun. We seldom see ourselves as others see us. So here see is a verb and ourselves is coming after a verb see, therefore it is also a reflexive pronoun. Okay. Now your exercise 4, underline the demonstrative and circle the indefinite pronouns in the following sentence. So what you have to do, you have to underline demonstrative pronouns and have to circle indefinite pronouns. I repeat, you have to underline demonstrative pronoun and have to circle indefinite pronoun. Demonstrative pronouns, for example, these, those, that. Okay, these are demonstrative pronoun, and indefinite pronoun are those pronouns which refers to any person, to any thing which is indefinite in any format. Okay, Can any of you do this sum? So here any you have to circle because it's a indefinite pronoun, and you have to underline this because this is a demonstrative pronoun. Second one, this is my book, that is yours. So here this and that are demonstrative pronoun, that's why you have to underline this and that. In third one, one hardly knows what to do. Here one is a indefinite pronoun, that's why you have to circle one. And in fourth one, none can tell how it happened. Here none is a indefinite pronoun, so you have to underline none. And in fifth one, give me one of those. Here one is a indefinite pronoun, so you have to circle one and underline those because those is demonstrative pronoun. And in sixth one, no need to fear that. Here that is demonstrative pronoun, that's why you have to underline that. And in seventh one, some were paid in gold and some in silver. Here some and some are indefinite pronouns, so you have to circle some and some. And in eighth one, one cannot help smiling at what he says. So here one is an indefinite pronoun, so you have to circle one. And in ninth one, these mangoes are not ripe, send us some ripe ones. So here these is a demonstrative pronoun, so that's why you have to underline these and have to circle some. Okay. And in tenth one, this is certainly a mistake, so here this is a pronoun. And which pronoun is this? This is demonstrative pronoun, so you have to underline this and it is a demonstrative pronoun. Let us do exercise 5. Underline the interrogative pronouns in the following sentences. Okay, so you have to underline questioning words from these sentences. First, which is your uncle's house? So here which you have to underline. Second one, who is there? Here who you have to underline. Third one, what is the matter? Here you have to underline what. Then in fourth, who made the top score? Here you have to underline who. Then in fifth one, which will you take? You have to underline which. In sixth, what is the news? Underline what. Seventh, what are those marks on your shirt? Underline what. Whom do you want? Underline whom. To whom were you speaking? Underline whom. Tenth, whose is this? Underline whose. And now exercise 6. Fill in the blanks by choosing the correct word from the brackets. So here what you have to do, you have to pick correct word and have to write in the blanks. Which is desk? Desk. Okay. Which is your desk? Okay. Now second one, which is desk cousin? Where is desk cousin? Where is their cousin? Which class is theirs? Which class is yours? Bring those books here. They are theirs books. My books. These are their pencils. They are not theirs. They are not ours. They are not our friends. They are theirs. They are not our friends. They are yours. Okay, so this is the end of your chapter number 6. Okay, thank you.